Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Le Paper Mario. In the last episode, we got this game started up. We already got through most of the prologue, but we're not quite at the end of the prologue yet. But we did make it to Toadtown at the end of last session. Let's talk to the people of the town. We haven't done that yet. All we've done is go back to my house and talk to Luigi. So what's up, Toad? The town's in an uproar. The princess kidnapped. The very castle uprooted. It's Bedlam. Please, Mario, save her highness. What's your name, sir? This Toad's always standing in front of the gate. Is it his job, maybe? He looks as if he's asleep on his feet, but he actually knows quite a bit about the town. I forgot about his voice. I need to do voices. I forgot. I don't need to, but, you know, whatever. Oh no! Doom! Danger! Princess Peach's castle's flown away, up into the sky! No castle! Horrors! Only a halt remains! Our beloved castle, where is it? Spread the word! Outrage! This Toad's always very excited about whatever news he has. He's a little crazy. Even so, it's a good idea to listen to him. He may be a little excitable, but he always has news. So yeah, it's good to learn about all these different Toads. Some of them will have names. Names that you'll want to remember for later. Also, there's a star piece there I won't be able to get until I can actually get across those things. It's basically a little dock for later. Oh, look, a whole family of Toads. Hello. Princess Peach was kidnapped, so I'm going to save her. But Mom told me I had to be a good boy and stay home. How come? He's a Toad Kid who wants to be really powerful. He thinks that having power solves everything. His way of thinking is a little bit different from mine. He's a good enough guy, though, when we play together. Okay. My dad works at the castle, so he's not usually at home, usually. But now the castle's gone, so he's at home. When I said I'm glad because dad's at home, I got scolded. What's up with that? He's one of the Toad Kids. He likes his father so much that he always tries to sneak into the castle. He's about the same age as I am. We sometimes play together when I come to Toad Town. I guess he's a pretty good friend of mine, I guess. This is one of those games where you have no nostalgia for it, but it still imbues a sense of nostalgia regardless. Ocarina of Time does the same thing. Yeah, I get that. I mean, it has nostalgia for me, obviously, but I can't understand why a game like this would invoke nostalgia for people who at least played games of the era or know about N64 games, just because it has that retro feel to it, you know? The earthquake when the castle flew away was terrifying. Everything was shaking. The ground, the houses, I fell right over. It was so horrifying that I just like to forget it ever happened. This family man ordinarily works at Peach's castle. He was on his day off when the castle disappeared. Talk about your basic lucky coincidence. Wow. He's a very reliable worker at the castle, but he never does his chores around the house. What a dick. Oh, busy, busy. The room doesn't get tidied up when my darling's home. She's the homemaker here. She's ordinarily very relaxed and easygoing. Since her lazy husband is home, she's working harder than ever right now. The housework piles up every day. Somehow she manages it all with no help. Where does she get the energy? I don't know, man. I don't know. This is your favorite N64 game. Yeah, you've definitely said that yesterday, so, you know. I understand why. This game's pretty good. Castle was taken away and Princess Peach was kidnapped. These are dark days. Everyone in town is suffering, and yet my heart cares for nothing but you, my sweet. Does that make me wicked? A little bit. My heart is the same, my love. It cares for you, none other. We are both wicked toads. This toad claims that he and his girl are in love. But just the other day, he told me he liked a different girl. What a cad. Oh, damn. What a fucking player. Those toads are in love. They're so in love, they don't even notice what's going on. Unless you like seeing public displays of affection, I wouldn't talk to them. They're shameless. PDA everywhere. Ew. All right. What's in this house? Library looking place. Hello. Oh, salutations. You're Mario, are you not? Of course I know who you are. I'm the wise toad, Rusty. Pleasure meeting you. As you can probably tell, I love books and read all the time. Because I'm so well read, I know all sorts of interesting facts. Whenever you visit with me, I'll be happy to share all of my knowledge with you. He's Rusty. Everyone says he's the smartest toad around. He's always happy to share his vast knowledge with people. He's filled me in plenty of things plenty of times. He knows a lot of things I can only guess at. Cool, cool, cool. Glad we could say hi. Bye. Yeah, anything Mario is kind of nostalgic just in general. I kind of agree with that statement too, Sparty. Alright. This should be our first shop of the game. What are they selling? They got fright jars, which scare enemies away sometimes. Sleepy sheeps would put them to sleep. Pow does 2 damage to all enemies. Fireflower does 3 to all enemies. Honey syrup heals 5 FP. And we have the mushroom, which stores 5 HP. Welcome to the Shroom Grocery. How can I help you today? So you can buy stuff, sell stuff. You can also check and claim stuff. That means you can put stuff in storage, because you can only hold so many items in your regular inventory. I'm actually going to store this Goom Nut because I'm not going to use it. I'm actually going to use it to cook later, probably, so definitely going to save that. Everything else we'll probably end up using, right? Yeah, we'll probably end up using most of that. Oh, yeah. We also have Super Mario Wonder coming out pretty soon. That's true. That's true. Another game that's kind of like, I'm going to play it at some point. I just don't know when. Hey, Mario, did you know you could carry up to 10 items? When you can't carry any more items, it's a good idea to go shop like this and ask him to hold items for you. You could even claim the items at any other shop. Pretty convenient, huh? Totes. This toad always stands in front of the shop. He knows all about items. He never moves as far as I can tell. Maybe he's trying to get a tan. Maybe. You wish you could play the Banjo-Kazooie games? You've watched Let's Plays of them, but don't have a Switch or Xbox Live. Or an N64 back in the day, so you never played it? I guess those are understandable reasons not to play Banjo-Kazooie, but yes. As soon as you can find a way to play them, RPG fan, I would. Those games are amazing. At least the first one. Banjo-Tooie is good, but a little more tedious. We'll just say that. Mario, have you gone back to your house yet? Luigi was wondering how you were doing. You can go home through that pipe in front of the main gate over there. You can enter the pipe by standing on the edge and pushing down on the control stick. Say, why don't you give me a tour of your house someday? Nah. He doesn't seem to have any particular reason to be at the dojo. He's not fighting. He just loiters around, checking out the fighters. Maybe he just likes watching tough guys. I bet he'll cheer for us if we challenge the master. So that's what this is over here. Above us on the top floor, there's a dojo. We are here, always, training at the dojo. Unless our master isn't here, in which case the dojo's closed. A letter just arrived saying the master will return soon. We will train again soon. That's Chan. He's one of the trainees who seems to always be at the dojo. He worships the master. I mean, it's all well and good for Chan to admire the master, but I prefer Mario. Hell yeah. Our master is wandering the world to purify his mind and train his body. Our master was a strong man. He's going to come back a very, very strong man. We will wait here, right here, until our master returns. Waiting is part of our training. He's one of the trainees who's always at the dojo. His name's Lee. He's like an older brother to Chan. Lee respects the master above all else and hangs on every word he says. Fucking Bruce Lee and Jackie Chan over here. Yeah, not awkward or anything for that guy to invite himself over to my house. Not at all. Oh, haha, you don't have it? The degree, Mario? The degree shows how strong you are. Haha, I have it. I fought at the dojo over there and got it from the master. I'm one bad toad. Oh, yeah? This toad has tried his skills at the dojo. That takes guts. Someday I'm going to try it all by myself. Alright, the dojo is something we'll be able to do later when the master returns. Peach's castle flew away. How could such a thing happen? What? What'll become of Princess Peach and the others who were at the castle? I'm scared. I, Felicity, I am so scared. She's the youngest of these three toad sisters. Apparently they call themselves the Three Beautiful Sisters. She says she's cute. I definitely think she's the cutest of the three. I don't know why. She's the oldest. Apparently they call themselves the Three Beautiful Sisters. Apparently they think they're attractive, but I guess for toads they are. I don't think that they're attractive. Goombas and toads think about beauty in different ways, I guess. What do you think, Mario? They look the same to me. Oh, shit. I didn't mean to talk to her again. She's the second oldest of these three toad sisters. Apparently, they call themselves the Three Beautiful Sisters. She obviously works pretty hard with makeup to look gorgeous. I guess. Kind of cute. What do you think, Mario? Eh, they'll all look the same to me, dog. Alright, anyway. Like I said, we won't be able to crow across those dock-looking things for a bit. So instead, we move on to the next part of town and explore some more. What's up? Hey, Mario. Word is you needed on Shooting Star Summit. You never been? Just go through that blue gate over there and bear right at Peach's Castle. Oops, I forgot. Peach's Castle is gone. This guy often knows rumors. He's counting on you, Mario. You won't let him down, will you? I might. Also, tree! Yeah! Another star piece. Hell yeah. The theft of our castle caused great destruction here. The worst of it happened in the center of town. It seemed to rain wood. As a result, we can't get to the southern part of town. The train station, the port, many important things lie south. Not being able to get there is a great inconvenience to me and to everyone. He's a toad who often thinks about going south. Maybe his girlfriend's there. Or maybe he just has a lot of friends in that area. He's pretty shady. Indeed. Gilderoy Lockhart. I'll be in my office getting ready. I just watched that recently, actually. Chamber Secrets. If he's earned his diploma at the dojo, why doesn't he go save the princess then? I know, right? Useless. Let's read about the underground news, y'all. I'm scribbling on the back of the notice board. How naughty. I heard Mario was defeated by Bowser. How ominous. Gossip-loving toad. So you'll get some dark rumors on the back, or dark rumors, whatever. Sneaky rumors on the back of this, but there's regular newsflash stuff on the front. Princess Peach kidnapped. Castle uprooted. A few days ago, Princess Peach's castle was stolen. She was inside and is presumed kidnapped. The whereabouts of the princess are unknown, and where the castle once stood there is now a gaping hole in the ground. According to the witnesses, the castle rose into the sky. As soon as we get new information, we'll post follow-up reports on this board. Thanks, reporter. Merlon is out. Well, fine then. I won't talk to Merlon, apparently. Nothing in that tree. Boring. You also love that he just mentions that the path to the south is blocked off and becomes known as the toad that wants to go south. I know, right? Labels, man. Labels. Do you see that blue pole in front of the post office? That's a road sign. You can find out what's there in Toad Town by checking out the signs. What am I telling you this for? I'm sure you know it's smart to read all the signs you see. Of course it is. This Toad, I'll tell you a secret. He's a huge fan of the princess. He told me once that he has a big collection of her photos. What a lovesick fool. You mean what a perv. The building with the spinning roof is Merlon's house. He's weird. He also happens to be as stubborn as a mule. He rarely comes out. As weird as he is, though, his talent is no joke. He can read the stars. He even predicted that you'd come back safe and sound. This friendly toad loves to run his mouth. He's a bit of a gossip. Okay. Up on Shooting Star Summit, there are these two siblings named Merlovely and Merlo. Merlovely tells fortune. She's really good at finding badges or star pieces. When you take star pieces to Merlo, he'll trade them for badges. These two could help, you know? You ought to go meet him. That's the plan when I go to the freaking Star Summit. Alright, over here, we got another little situation. Hey, mister. You're a customer, aren't you? Dad's preparing to open the shop soon. I guess you gotta wait a little while. This is Ruff. How's Ralph's... He's Ralph's kid. He looks just like Ralph, right? He's supposed to be helping, but it looks like he's in pain. Well, it's Ralph's problem, not mine. Hey, what's up? Good to meet you, bud. Ralph's the name. I'm starting up a little town, up a little business in Toad Town. I'm still setting up, though. I want to see you back here when we open up, alright? Alright. This guy's pretty funky. His name's Ralph. He sells badges. He travels all over the world buying and selling things. I'm a little jealous. Alright, so this will be a bad shop later. Can't buy anything yet. What else we got around here? You never understood why those shopkeepers, what those shopkeepers are supposed to be. Are they Yoshis or some kind of dinos? Yeah. They basically look like a dino that walks on two legs. Yeah, pretty much. Water and dirt, sunshine, power. Beautiful blooms, beautiful flowers. Hello, my name's Minty. Minty, huh? Please enjoy the beauty of this garden, this flower garden. I've heard there's a lovely flower we don't have here. Supposedly, bubbulbs have the only known seeds. This is what a bubbulb looks like. If you find a bubbulb, could you get seeds for me? I'll plant them in this flower garden and raise them lovingly. Sure. Big side quest for the game. She takes care of the flowers. Her name's Minty. Nobody matches her skill at growing flowers. She must have a green thumb. Flowers feel Minty's love and show it in their blooms. Cool. Alright. What's up, dog? Look at Minty, always with the flowers. She's as pretty as a rose. Just watching her from a distance makes me happy, heart. You happy. Seems like this toad is always in love with someone. Right now he likes Minty. I think he's in good spirits. As long as he can hear near her, he'll be happy. Indeed. Alright, before I go talk to those weird toads over there, I think they said the road south was blocked. Let's confirm that. Yeah, okay, it's blocked by a bunch of stuff. These building materials used to be stacked by the road, but they all came down when the earthquake hit. Unfortunately, it's impossible to go through the south side of town with all this scattered wood. Don't worry, we're restacking it as quickly as possible. I know it's inconvenient, but please bear with us while we get everything in order. It might take till the end of chapter one, but we'll see. This toad is diligent and very hardworking. He has a great work ethic. I heard he has a bit of a crush on Merlovely, who lives on Shooting Star Summit. Well, we're going to go visit her in a moment. Alright, we got a couple more buildings. We got the post office back over here. Let's go say what's up to the people there. And I think there's one more building to the right. Alright, we got the... This is the guy that delivered our letter at the beginning of the game. Greetings. The name's Paracarry. I delivered letters. His name is Paracarry. He's a paratrooper who works for the post office. He's well known for being the slowest mailman around. A slow mailman? That can't be good. Wow. Slowest mailman around. Gotta love it. Yes, hello. This is the post office. You can read any letters that arrive for you or for your other party members. Please drop by now and then to check and see if you've received any mail. Well, oh, you seem to have some mail. Which one would you like to read? I already have mail. Oh, Goombario has mail. Yeah, he not only is the slowest mailman, he's the only mailman. So he's the fastest and the slowest all in one. Goombario got a letter apparently from the red and blue Goombas. All right then, here you go. Goombario, you were a lot stronger than you look. We figured you were just some punk Goomba hanging around the Mario. Anyway, you proved yourself to us and you showed us that being good is as important as being strong. So when you come back, do you think maybe we could be friends? Please say yes. We'll be waiting. Red and blue Mario, or Goomba Bros. We'll keep the letters for you. Come on by anytime when you want to read the letters. Dope. All right, so yeah, we're going to stop by here occasionally and see if people have letters. This way your mail will never be too early. Also, thank you for the follow, Corpse Kitsune. I can't read it without seeing it. Corpse Kitsune, thank you for the follow. Jesus Christ. Corpse Kitsune. I can say that, I swear. Alright. Anyway, we have another sleepy place if we need to stay. I think we're probably fine. Really? You seem to be in fine shape. You sure you want to take a nap? Nah, we good. Take my time with that? Yeah. This is the manager of Toad House. These havens are all over the world, usually named by a toad, manned by a toad. When you're exhausted, you should stay at one and recover. Indeed. Or there's the Clock Town mailman, who's so regimented with his schedule that he won't even flee from the moon. I know, right? Wow, these toads do not look friendly. Hello. It's dangerous out there. I wouldn't go. Yeah, you shouldn't go. Nope, no go. Sorry, but no. All right, well, I guess these guys are blocking my way. Guess we have no choice but to go to the Shooting Star Summit. Not that I didn't want to go there. I just wanted to explore in its entirety. By the way, can I smack this sign? I can read it. North Peach's Castle, West Main Gate, East Pleasant Path, and South Port Station. Well, that's cool. Aren't they supposed to say, take this and hand you a sword? I know, right? Alright, well, here's where Princess Peach's Castle used to be. I can't believe the Princess Peach's Castle was just here a little while ago. Wow. I was in the castle when it started to shake, but my lightning quick feet got me out. I know Luigi made it out along with me, maybe a few others, but everyone else was taken. He's a toad. He never fails to go for a walk, even if it's nasty out. He also loves cleaning for some reason. He cleans like crazy. Oh yeah? Like crazy. You were looking for a stream to chill in while you play on your 3DS? Well, hopefully you found the right place, because I read all the dialogue. It's not stressful here unless Sparty lies to your face and yet stresses you out, because he will do that. Lower this microphone. I just realized, like, all up in my face on the camera. Anyway, guys, we're headed to Shooting Star Summit. Let's go. It's rain and star bits. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah, that chill-ass star bit music, y'all. Shooting Star Summit this way. This is a place to de-stress, not to fall into distress. Shut up, Mario. Stop saying it's not the place to pre people to chill. It absolutely is. Anyway, we're going to stop by Merlovely's house real quick. You can't listen to this music and not feel chill. A bit of chaos never hurt nobody. True. Am I afraid that you'll scare people away? No. Just saying. You might. Alright, so this box will be important for later. Just note that it's here. Anyway, what's up, Mer Lovely? Ah, my. Hello there, Mario. This spot is a little tight for fortune telling. If you want your fortune read, talk to me over the counter. Sure. Ah, my. Heart, I foresaw your arrival, Mario. My name is Mer Lovely. I'm a stunning fortune teller. My noble calling is to read fortunes while looking absolutely ravishing. I can help you find what you seek. My twinkle star here will show me all that's hidden. My heart. Tell me, shall I read your fortune? Is it free? It's not free. Pass. Super block. Oh. So star pieces and badges are obvious. Super block, I think, is the blocks that we haven't seen one yet. But they'll let us upgrade our party members to be stronger. We can locate those too, though. That's nice. You have enough homies. You'll be fine. We can afford to scare some away. Come on, man. We always want more homies. Yeah, at least I'm playing something chill and not something where I get all aggro. For sure. You should be. I am thankful that you're not Walker Morrow. I am. Very, very thankful. My heart. Are you sure? If you ever seek something, please call upon me again. If it didn't cost me money, I would do it, but I'm good. All right, let's go say hi to her house companion. Her brother, maybe? I don't even know. What's up, dude? I'm the famous Merlot of Shooting Star Summit. I collect star pieces. I have the biggest collection. Mister, you have any star pieces? If you do, I'll swap some cool badges for them. How's about it? Let's swap. Sure. Which badges do you want to swap for? Don't say his name too many times or he might appear. Shit, he might already be lurking right now. You once raged at Minecraft. A chicken was refusing to cooperate with you. F that chicken. F it. Kill it. Yeah, there you go. Stare into a mirror and say his name or make some fake nudes of Brie Larson. Whoever it takes to summon his bitch ass. All right, anyway, we have 4 star pieces right now. So attack effects A. This is just to make your attack have sound effects. So I will grab this eventually or maybe right now. The more damage you take, the more coins you receive. I kind of think I'm going to grab this because I can get some coins early in the game. Get some early coins. You need 2 BP to equip it, though. But I'll take it anyways. It's fine. Even if I can't equip it yet, I'll get it so I can use it when I want to. And then this one lets you not get hit by a first strike, which is also nice. Or we can save our star pieces to buy one that's more expensive. There's actually some pretty good shit here. This is one you definitely want. Pretty lucky. It's kind of like the close call badge, but even better. This one lets you stick. Oh, you don't. This is like a status effect defense. No poison, no dizziness. This is basically a regen badge for your hearts. This is for your flowers. Make it possible to. Oh, this is nice to see your enemy's HP so you don't have to tattle them. But if you tattle everyone, this becomes redundant. Zap Tap's really nice because you can do some damage to enemies when they hit you. Heart Finder and Flower Finder make it so enemies drop hearts and flowers more often. HP Drain makes your attack actually drain 1 HP when you attack. Oh, it actually makes my attack weaker, though, which is lame. Money. Oh, this one lets the enemies drop more money. This one actually gives you an FP back every time you attack. Oh, sure. Okay. And then Power Plus, which actually just straight up gives your hammer and jump attacks plus 1 power, which is absolutely savage. Plus 1 attack power in this game is ridiculous. Because you only really get that attack power bump when you get a new hammer or new boots for your feet. Oh, I didn't buy anything, did I? Do I want the chill out badge or do I just want to move on? I'll grab this attack effects badge so we can mess with it when I feel like it. It doesn't cost anything to equip it, so it's worth grabbing. Yeah, if Walker was here when I was playing that other Castlevania game, I think, for a minute. You did actually kill that chicken in Minecraft? Nice. Sir, please don't get the pen. No, not in there. In the, No! Hi, Novalite. How are you today? Welcome in. Sorry, the chat has been moving faster than I've been keeping up with. Yeah, as soon as I play Castlevania Dawn of Sorrow on the 3DS, or the DS, whatever it is on, Walker will appear magically. Alright, anyway. We've hung out with the people in the house. Let's go to the actual top of the summit and see what we need to do here. Walker is technically lurking right now. Why am I not surprised? He does leave me on lurk a lot. but he doesn't like the chat unless he's either A, paying attention and we call him out, or B, I'm playing a game he wants to chat about. Anyway, you recently started getting into Mario RPGs. They always looked fun, but Mario and Luigi games drew you in. Those are games I actually need to play as well. Maybe after the new Paper Mario remake comes out, I'll play the Mario and Luigi games finally. Because the only one I've played any of is the Superstar Saga, which is the first one. And I've never played any of the other ones at all. If you guys keep saying his name or making me say his name, he might actually come in. So be careful what you wish for. You're actually playing Superstar Saga right now? Nice. GG. It's a fun game. Alright, let's go talk to the damn Elder Star, the Eld Star.
Welcome, Mario. We've been waiting for you. We're the seven star spirits. Our job is to grant the wishes of good people from our home into Starhaven. From our home in Starhaven, a place higher beyond the sky. We're going to tell you something incredibly important. Please listen carefully. The other day, Bowser and his followers invaded our peaceful Starhaven. They stole our prized treasure, the Star Rod, which we've cared for since the beginning of time.
The Star Rod is powerful beyond belief. It can grant any wish. For as long as we can remember, Bowser has been making wishes like, for instance... Wishes like, for instance... I'd like to trounce Mario, or I want Princess Peach to like me. Of course, stars ignore such selfish wishes. Wishes. As a result, his wishes were never granted.
And Bowser, that fiend. When he found out we were ignoring his wishes, he came and stole the Star Rod so he could grant his own wishes. He seems content right now, mainly because he defeated you and captured the princess. Soon enough, though, I fear he will wish for more, and then terrible things will happen.
Dude, it's like the responsibility of the seven star spirits to keep the Star Rod safe, bruh, and use it properly. We must get the Star Rod back from Bowser and return it to its rightful place, bruh. In order to do this, Mario, we need your help.
Sadly, right now you are not strong enough to challenge Bowser. He has made himself all-powerful by making wishes with the Star Rod. He is terrible to behold.
Once we, seven star spirits, are reunited in Starhaven, we can give you the power to fight Bowser even with his newfound strength. With our help, you can prevail.
I didn't even catch what he said. Mario, we are...
Alas, we've nearly...
What was this guy's voice again? I want to say I did like the,
Alas, we've nearly exhausted our power to talk to you. Although it looks like we're there beside you, it is only an illusion. We are using all of our strength to communicate with you over a great distance, but even now our strength is fading. We've been caught and we are being beheld by Bowser's followers in different places throughout the kingdom, Mushroom Kingdom. Please, Mario, first of all, you must rescue us.
In order to take the Star Rod back from Bowser and save Princess Peach, we need your help. Please, Mario, you are our last hope, and we will...
Mario, it looks like things are a lot more serious than I thought, bro. You think the princess is gonna be alright? I'm really worried about her.
Indeed. Alright, so we might be finishing up the prologue here very soon. Anyway, you're just getting reminded why you love Luigi so much. Luigi's awesome. Alright, and back to your worky lurky, Mario. Alrighty. See you. Bye. See you in like an hour and a half. Alright, back to the castle, y'all. I think we really are about to wrap up the prologue, actually.
Mario's probably hurt. Everyone's in prison. The Mushroom Kingdom will be destroyed if things continue the way they're going. Something must be done. If only somebody could help me.
I'll help you, Princess. My dear Princess Peach, how are you doing this fine day?
So hold on, wait. You remember another streamer that did voices for characters? You managed to make him give characters based on nationality. Goombas were Indian. Stars were Soviets. That's funny, actually. Everyone's in prison? Did Mario get caught doing shrooms again? Apparently, Flammy. What's up? How you doing?
It's no use waiting for Mario. Oh, no, this is the old lady.
It's no use waiting for Mario this time, my dear. We're so high above the sky right now, even Mario doesn't have a chance of reaching us up here.
You know, Princess, as long as I have this star rod, no one in the Mushroom Kingdom can touch me. You know the power that grants everyone wishes? It's mine. Isn't that just wonderful?
Yeah. Imagine what it's like down in your kingdom. Your subjects must be so upset because their wishes aren't being granted. Oh, how delightful. They deserve it for the way they've treated us Koopas over the years.
If you know, if you you want anything, all you need to do is ask me, Princess. I can grant wishes. Of course, only grant requests that I like. Anyway, think about it. You take care, Princess Peach. Enjoy your stay here.
You watch yourself, Princess. You'd better not cause trouble.
Oh, please. If only somebody could help me.
Knock, knock, mother...
Huh?
Here comes the help, baby.
Anyway. Hello, Princess Peach. Pleased to meet you. My name's Twink. But you're a star kid, aren't you? How'd you get here? I came from Starhaven to grant your wish. It's our job to grant wishes, you know. Oh, you came because I wish that somebody could help me? Yes, of course. Oh, that's just great. Thank you so much for coming. Here's my wish. Go right now and take that star rod back from Bowser, okay? Think you could do it?
Sorry. That's a little much for a novice star like me.
I mean, one of the artful star spirits of Starhaven could grant a wish like that.
Jesus Christ, it's fucking yawn.
I'm so sorry. Please ask for something easy, something a small star can do.
Then, can you take me away from here? Everyone in my castle has been captured and I have to save them all as soon as possible.
Oh, I'm sorry. I can't grant that wish either, I'm afraid. Actually, I just got called up to the sky a day ago, so I can't do big wishes yet. If I were a more splendid star, maybe I could actually help.
Who the fuck summoned this kid? Couldn't we have gotten any of the other damn stars up there? We got this fucking little bastard. Like, seriously.
The hell? It's alright. Don't be sad, Twink. Mario will definitely do something to save us all. He's probably coming right now. Oh, Twink. Do you think you could find Mario? I want you to give this to him.
Give what to me? What's that?
This is a lucky star, isn't it?
Okay, I'll do it, Princess Peach. I'll fly to the Mushroom Kingdom just as quick as I can.
Alright, dope. See ya.
Oh, wait, Twink. Wait one second. Can you also... Please tell Mario that... I'm fine and he shouldn't worry, okay? Can you tell him that?
Of course. I'll tell him your exact words, Princess Peach. Definitely. Now don't despair.
I'll be back soon, so stay safe till I return, okay? Jesus, almost had a burp there for a second. 30 or so games later, Peach comes up with a wish idea to escape.
Please marry me on the moon. Needless to say, it didn't work out as planned. Indeed. Mario, where are you?
Not here, but someday. Alright. I guess we're gonna head out of Star Road. See ya! That music is chill as hell, though, for real. Ouch!
Oh, sorry. I'm in a huge hurry. Oh, you're Mario, aren't you? Thank the stars I found you.
Well then, that was easy.
How do you do? I'm Twink. Princess Peach asked me to bring something to you.
Yes, here it is.
Kept it in my fucking pocket that I don't have.
Here, this is it. Take it.
You got the lucky star. Star-shaped pendant that lets you use the action command, which is what I've been waiting for. Thank God.
That's the lucky star from Princess Peach.
Now that it's yours, you can use the action command. May I take a moment to explain what the action command is?
Sure.
Okay, let me explain. Let me see. Hang on, you. You, behind Mario. Would you mind helping me demonstrate something?
Me? The name is Goombario. Of course I'll help.
Well, Mario and Goombario, let's begin.
Time to practice.
Anyway, your internet crashed for about 5 minutes, RPG fan. Well, then welcome back. Sorry you missed a little bit, but welcome back.
First, Mario, choose the jump command and then decide which enemy you want to attack.
Yeah, got it.
Once you decide on the enemy, the explanation of the action command will appear. Boop! Right now, just before stomping on the enemy. Press A to this exact moment.
Alright, we'll have to practice, but here we go.
When you see the knights appear, it means you successfully used the action command. When you do, you'll increase the amount of damage you do.
Okay, now this time, Goombario, you try to attack Mario.
Okay, here it comes, Mario! Boop! Right now.
Press A just before the attack strikes you, and you'll block it.
Yep.
Successfully use the action command. This will reduce the amount of damage. Often you'll have to use the damage doing things to make use of the action command. It depends on the attack. Try attacking with the hammer. Once you choose enemy to attack, control stick to the left. And you let go when the star happens. More damage. Alright, you successfully use action command. Well, Mario, you understand? Yes, I do. I'm good. I'm good. We'll just practice it on enemies. It'll be fine. Goombario also has an action command to bounce more as well. Once you understand how to use the action command properly, you'll be even more powerful.
Terrific! You'll be much tougher in battle now.
Hell yeah, we will.
Here you are.
Who is it? Oh. It's a regular flying Koopa, Magic Koopa.
What? Can't be. Were you following me? What a foolish star kid. I knew that if I followed you, I'd find Mario. If I defeat Mario right now, I'll be famous. I'll tell Kami Koopa, and she'll shower me with praise. She'll give me a raise. Here I come.
Okay, I guess we're going to fight a Magic Koopa. All right. Well, first things first, let's tattle this fool. This is a Magic Koopa. Magic Koopas use magical rods. HP 8, attack power 3. Holy moly. Magic attacks are no joke, Mario. You'd better take these guys seriously. I take them dead seriously. Ready for a power jump, y'all? Boop! Oh, I was too late. Oh, well. Damn it, I didn't block it. Power jump him again. Boop! I did do more damage. It's not a double bounce, but I did do more damage. And you're dead. Practice those action commands. Yeah, the action commands in this game are basically what make the game fun. Past that, it's just a turn-based RPG. But with the action commands, this game is very fun. Especially with all the different abilities and stuff you get. It adds a lot more to the fun. You'll see as we go.
Well done, Mario. You're as strong as they say. I know that you'll be able to defeat Bowser. I'm going to return to Princess Peach's side. I'm not strong enough to really help her, but at least I can tell her you're okay. Well, Mario, see you later. I guess he could just be my regular voice. I mean, we're going to see him a bit. Quite a bit. So, yeah.
Oh dear, I almost forgot to tell you the message from Princess Peach. I'm alright, so don't worry about me. That's exactly what she said. I get the feeling, though, that she's very lonely. Anyway, I'll do my best to help the both of you. But please be brave. You must save Princess Peach.
Oh yeah. There he goes, back to Bowser's castle. What a brave little guy. Okay, Mario, let's get down to business.
Let's get down to business to defeat Koopas. Alright. Does these guys say anything new? What kind of chance do we have? I'm rooting for you, Mario. You gotta save the princess. Everyone else. You got it, dude. Alright. We're blowing back to town now.
Oh, Mario. Merlon was looking for you. He lives in that house with the spinning roof. He asked me to tell you to go meet him at his house. I was just about to go look for you, but here you are.
It's rare for Merlon to call somebody over to his house.
He's a bit eccentric. Even when he has visitors, it's rare for him to come out of the house at all.
Alright then, let's go say hi.
What RPGs have your favorite turn-based combat systems? For me, it's Undertale, Valkyrie Profile, SMT Nocturne.
Merlon is out.
Wait, what do you mean he's out? He said he invited me to his house. How can he be out? What? Why do you keep on knocking? I'm telling you, he's out. Are you sure about that? What the? Why is someone sleeping in front of my house? Wait a minute. That face seems very familiar to me. Oh, maybe. Nah, yes, it must be. You're Mario. I've been waiting for you. You should have come earlier. Well, you're here now. Come in. Jesus. Merlon, what a character. I don't have an answer for your question right now, RPG fan. I'd really have to think about it. Where to begin? My name is Merlin. Merlon, whatever. I'm a wizard. When I was reading the stars the other day, an oracle came to me. What I discovered is very important, and it concerns you. But before I tell you about it, there are other things of which I must speak. It is a very long story, but I'll try to shorten it. Where should I start? It was in the old days. One of my ancestors was up on Shooting Star Summit, and as usual... But one day it happened, and suddenly a great appeared, and I, standing face to face... Then, the far away, the pious was raised up, me up, and it was amazing. I was still so young then, I believed in, but our hearts were... And then, so... Damn, I think Mario's falling asleep over here, dude. Literally. Jesus Christ. And that's all that... What did it say? And that's all that matters. Huh? Hey, Mario, were you listening to me? Absolutely. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Alright. That's why I'm able to help you. If you get lost during your adventure, you can come to me. I can predict the path you should take for a small price. Right now, your main goal must be to save Princess Peach as quickly as humanly possible, but according to my second sight, your path must first take you to the Great Fortress of the Koopa Bros. To reach the Koopa Bros Fortress, head east on the road in front of the Toad House. Thank you very much, sir. Bye. Yeah, basically, if you want to stay up for that story, you gotta need the all-nighter mask, you know, for Majora's. Alright, so is the shop open over here yet? It does not look open yet. We'll probably have to actually get into Chapter 1 for things to start changing. So let's go over here and see if we can activate Chapter 1. You don't want to go out there. It's way too dangerous. Going to Koopa Bros. Fortress would be a huge mistake. Definitely, definitely don't go. Most of all, though, you shouldn't go ask old man Merlon for help. That would be really bad news for us. I mean, for you. Don't even think about it. But I already know what y'all are about. Maybe I have to go talk to Merlon to get these guys out of my way. Is it obvious what those guys are? Should be. SMT Nocturne's a good choice. The negotiation system sucks, though. Same as in Persona 5. I hate the negotiation system. I don't care what anyone says. It was never any good. The negotiation system to, like, get the personas to join you, you mean? It's okay. I don't love it, though. Huh, Mario. Do you want me to predict the path you should take? It'll cost you 5 coins. Is that acceptable? Nah. You don't want me to predict the future? If you require something other than fortune telling, stand beside me. Yeah, there we go. Come again? Strange toads blocking the east side of Toad Town. That shouldn't be. That's ridiculous. Such a thing has never been heard of. Never! I'll get to the bottom of this. Follow me over there. I'll see what's going on. Let's watch Merlon fuck these guys up, shall we? Merlon like, y'all don't belong here. See ya! Are these the strange toads you were talking about? I told you that you can't pass. Take off. You aren't toads, are you? We don't know what you're talking about. Yeah, what gives? Ask anyone. We're just cute ordinary toads hanging out. Reveal your true selves. Boom. Damn, they got zapped. Oh! Huh, just as I thought. You're the Koopa Bros. Heh. How'd you guess it was us? We were perfectly disguised. Shucks. Black, yellow, green, we retreat. For now. Mario, those imposters were none other than the Koopa Brothers. You must pursue them to their hideout, the Koopa Bros. Fortress. Oh, Mario, there's one part of your fortune I haven't revealed. To get to the Koopa Bros. Fortress, you'll need help from a blue-shelled Koopa.
This is a strange portent. In Koopa Village, you might find something that will clear it up. I must return home now. Blue-shelled Koopa, you say? Sounds good. Let's pop a save, though. We haven't really made any saves since our, like, midpoint autosave. But officially, let's start Chapter 1, y'all. Here we go. We won't be able to get very far into this right now, but we can at least get started. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, God! I tried to hit him with the hammer. That was a poor choice. I should have just bounced on his ass. All right. I'm going to scan that fool. Actually, you know what? We want to hit this fool. Knock him on his ass. It'll be smart in the long run. There's a Koopa Troopa. Everybody knows Koopa Troopas. They're Bowser's followers. Max HP 4. Attacking 1-1. Their shells are hard. If you can flip them over, their defense power falls to 0, and it'll become much easier for you to defeat them. You can flip him with a pow block or a jump attack. I already flipped his ass. Damn, I gotta practice blocking, man. Gotta practice blocking and stomping. Hell yeah. Got the Koopa dead. Got it! Nice. Got him. There's a little bit of leeway with the bounce moves, so you don't have to be perfect. But you just gotta make sure you hit it before you land. Not as you land, before you land. Paratroopas, huh? Long time no see, boyo. Aw, oh, I knew I was gonna fuck that up. I knew I was going to. Damn it. Gotta practice those blocks and dodges, man. They'll come to save you in the long run, so you gotta practice it for sure. One thing about being on Chapter 1 already, we might be able to actually make it to the Koopa Village before we end this off. Got him. And luckily, we shouldn't run into too many new enemies besides the Koopa Troopa that we fought, at least for a minute. Dizzy Attack Badge. I wonder if I have enough BP to level or to equip any of these badges. So they're all worth 2, the ones I have right now. Hammer Throw, Payoff, and Dizzy Attack. We also have this badge. You know what? Let's see what sound effect it adds and see if we like it or not. I don't think I like that. I don't like that one. It's kind of annoying, actually. I'd rather just have that regular hammer sound. Free Fright Jar, though. That's cool. I don't think I like that sound very much. Ooh, a POW block. Nice. Boop! Got him. Worth knocking them both on their ass. So they'll actually both be on their ass for the beginning of the fight. So no damage will be had. I love it. Haha. I'm falling and I can't get up. You're dead. See ya. See ya. Wouldn't wanna fucking be ya. Yep, Koopas can be rendered ineffective if you just knock them on their ass. Yeah, he should have gotten life alert. Help, I'm falling and I can't get up. Boop. Hey, look, a switch. Maybe that'll get us across Zawata. Hell yeah. Anything else in the tree? No. There's something up here, too. It's a Goomba. Or, yeah, it's a spiky Goomba. Get pounded on, son. Can't really stomp these guys, so time to pound it.
I don't think I can do anything with the Goombario on this turn, unfortunately. So do nothing it is. Nice. Good block, good block. I do not like this wonky hammer sound. I think I might take it off. After I fight these guys, of course. Head bump. Boop. See you. Now, I should be able to hammer time these guys in one hit, as long as I do this right. Boop. Adios. But now you guys have the idea of how the attacks effect sounds, attack effects sound badges works. So, attack sound effects badges, that's what I'm trying to say. So, yeah, probably won't use that one anymore. Not the greatest sound in the world. Hey, a sleepy sheepy. Whoa! 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 There we go. Got him. You want to know what you just noticed? What did you just notice, Mara? I'm wearing your shirt? That's a funny statement. I'm wearing our shirt, aka my shirt. If you guys can't see my shirt, by the way, it's Squall. It's pretty dope. I was pretty excited to get this shirt. No, no, no. You know Squall's my favorite, man. Why do you think I bought this shirt for me? Of course I like Squall also. Come on, man. Do I wear other articles of her clothing? Wouldn't you like to know, Sparty? I've been trying, man. Wow. No other secret blocks or anything. Cool. Toad Town, Koopa Bro, Koopa Village. I definitely want to go to Koopa Village. I think if I run around this, yeah, he'll drop hearts, which is awesome. I remembered that. FP, baby, honey syrup. I don't want to go to Koopa Bros Fortress yet. I want to go to Koopa Village first. He'll pose like that suntan lotion, baby? What do you mean? What? Oh, Lord. Where the dog is ripping on these. Oh my god. Morrow, you're ridiculous. Hey, look, another badge. Hey, another attack effects badge. Well, let's take a listen to this one, see if it sounds any better than the other one. The other one was terrible. Boop, boop, boop. Well, it's also kind of annoying, but less annoying than the other one. Who doesn't love a good slide whistle? Am I right? Alright, we made it to Koopa Village. Can it be? Are you Mario? Welcome to Koopa Village. I wish we could really welcome you, but we're in big trouble. Can't you see what kind of madness is going on? This village is in an uproar because of the fuzzies. You do know what fuzzies are like, don't you, Mario? They look like this. Mean guys. They're really naughty. The naughtiest. Naughty, naughty. Oh no, stupid fuzzy. Get back here with my shell. Come here, you bitch. Got him. It should have a baby Mario crying sound effect. Oh my god, that'd be annoying, actually. Fuzzies not to be confused with furries, indeed. Wow. Oh, thank you, Mario. I owe you one.
I just can't walk around without my shell on. Talk about embarrassing. Mario, be sure to keep your shell safe from fuzzies, all right? Oops, you don't have one. Well, watch your overalls.
All right. Coin. So anyway, I think we actually have to defeat all the fuzzies. Come here, you fucker. Now, these fuzzies are annoying as shit. There we go. Got them. Got another one. See ya. I'll get your shell down, sir. There you go.
Huh, you're the best. Thank you very much.
You're welcome very much. Ooh, dried shroom. It heals only one, but we got it. Can I go into the shop and store some shit? Because my inventory is hella full now. Alright, let's check some stuff real quick. By the way, whatever you check, you can claim at any shop. Just FYI. Super Shroom. Sleepy Sheep. I'll save one. What else do I got? I'll save that Dried Shroom. It's only worth 1 HP. Guess I can hold on to the rest. Wow. Morrow. Welcome to the Toad House. No, I'm good. We're good. We gotta help out all these people with the fuzzy situation. Your shell's up here.
Thanks, Mario! This shell was made to order, so that's why it fits me so well. I mean, how cool do I look?
You look the same as all the rest of the fools, I'm not gonna lie.
Ooh.
Free Koopa Leaf. Koopa Leafs are nice for cooking as well. Oh, hi, random guy with two ba-bombs. Supposedly these ba-bombs recently ran away from Koopa Bros Fortress. Of course things aren't much better here in the village. The fuzzies are running wild. Huh? Me? I don't leave my house because I couldn't bear it if the fuzzies made a fool of me. They'd probably take my shell and play with it. I know I don't look cool without my shell. Nope. No thank you. Just rather stay here and listen to music. We're ba-bombs. We just ran away from Koopa Bros Fortress. We thought we'd at least find some peace here in the village. Boy, were we wrong. The fuzzies are running around here, all around here. All we want is a little peace. You must listen. The Koopa Bros in the fortress worked us too hard. As far as they're concerned, laborers have no rights. I will never ever go back to work in such a terrible place. Okay. Golden Oldie Station, huh? It is like a remix to an old song. So that's how they get all those Koopa shells from Mario Kart games. They send fuzzies to steal them from the Koopa Village. Exactly. Anyway, let's help out Koopa Village with this fuzzy situation before we maybe call this session for the day. Let's get rid of these dang fuzzies, huh? There's fuzzies everywhere! Fuzzy? How am I supposed to get this fool? Fuzzy took my shell. I ran after him, but it just laughed and taunted me. How the fuck am I supposed to get that guy? You fuzzies won't be me. Behold my power. Gah! Whoa. How was that? Superpower, wasn't it? I don't really know how I'm supposed to catch all these fucking things, but... There's that shell. I might have known. You're so clever, Mario. I know, right? I'm the cleverest. What can I say? How am I supposed to get all these fools? Got them. Bastard. Alright. Thank you.
Typical Mario style. You were just as cool as I heard you were. I know, right? I'm the coolest. Ah, come on. I had him. Yo, what's up, decency spreader? You're out there doing the work of the Lord, spreading that decency, sir? Well, just know that your decency will go not very far around here. Damn it! Fuck this fuzzy. Damn it! Ooh. Bitch! Ooh. Oh, come on! You're a piece of trash! Don't anyone ever let tell you different, Fuzzy Boy? Ah, come on! Ooh. Getting salty right now. What the f- Ooh. Why? Are you indecent? Very. These fuzzies are trying to make the Koopas indecent in public, indeed. Fuck! God, this is annoying as hell. Oh, come on! Ooh. I'm getting salty about this now. Why is it so hard? Why is it so difficult? Can I spin into them? Would that work? I don't think I can spin into them. Why can't... Dude. What if I do it when he comes around? What if I get him right here? Nope. Wow, I got him. Unbelievable that I actually got him. Boy, vey. Alright, now I'm gonna check the houses to make sure I got all the fuzzies, because there might be one inside of a house. Oh, there's one in the tree, apparently. That's good to check. Hey, look, it's the old man. What's up?
What in the world's coming to you when a Koopa can't even step outside for fear of fuzzies? I've lived many, many, many years, and this is the first time I've seen anything like this.
Fucking fuzzies, man. I tell you what. Who's there? I'm kind of busy right now. Oh, hello. What? Could it be? Aren't you Mario? You care? You are. My name's Cooper. Oh, I'm so psyched to meet you. Us meeting here has got to be fate or something. I need a huge favor. I hope you'll help me out. This wild fuzzy took my shell, which next to my life is the most important thing I have. I can't go without my shell. Period. Way too embarrassing. The problem is, the fuzzies are too fast for me to catch alone. So if you don't mind, can you help me get my shell back? I'm begging you. Hey, Mario, it looks like he's in a bad way. We ought to help him out. Alright. The fuzzy that took my shell is just inside my house. I'll guard the door while you grab him like Wump. Alright, I'll Wump him. Yeah, exactly. You're lucky I have played this before, Decency Spreader, because otherwise I'd be annoyed that you're asking about later stuff, but yeah, anyway. Ugh, now we gotta chase this fucker down. Cool. Oh boy. There's so many fuzzies! Come back to me! I forgot this part was such an ordeal, otherwise I would have just stopped before I did this. Oh well. Alright, get ready. Mjork, Mjork! Come get it if you can, Yanya! Alright, watch for the blue.
Guess where I'm hiding. Watch for the blue. I know where you are, bitch. Ding ding, motherfucker. Not bad, chump, but that was just a warm-up. Bring it, bitch. Mjork, guess where I'm hiding. I don't need to guess, bitch. Wow, right back where you started, bitch. Mjork, Mjork, you got me twice. Must have been luck. Now I'm serious. Okay. Guess where I'm hiding. I think he went to the left last. No, it was back where he started. Motherfucker. It was back where he started. I couldn't tell if he went left or right there at the last second. I guess I'll tattle these fools. They must have more than 2 HP. 3 HP. The problem with fuzzies is their quickness. It's really tough to time their attacks. If they latch onto you, watch out. They'll absorb your HP. Yeah, I know. I know. Hey, I blocked it. Damn it. Didn't block that one, though. Lucky for me, that wasn't the harder one to kill. One fuzzy down. Press it too early again. That's okay. Victorious! Alright. Drop out of the tree, you fuck. Guess where I'm hiding? Let's try that again. I want to say he went back to his starting point again. What a cheater. No, no! I give uncle. Here, take the stupid shell. Yeah, we got a shell back. You're too tough for me. I won't be bad anymore, I promise. Maybe. Maybe. Sassy little bastard. Maybe. Can't shake that. Can't shake these bushes? That surprises me, actually. Oh, maybe I can after I talk to him. Mario, there you are. I realize I have to take a stand against the fuzzies. If I can't get my own shell, I'll lose my reputation. I don't even care that I have no shell on. I'm gonna show those fuzzies what's what. We already got the shell back, bro. Oh, yes, yes! This is my shell, alright? Oh, yeah, got my shell back, uh-huh. You're the greatest, Mario. I owe you big time. Good to hear you're happy. Say, Mario, I have an idea. Do you happen to know Professor Colorado? Naturally, he's a Koopa who's a professor of archaeology. He's also known as an explorer. Right, well, I live next to him. I've been admiring Professor Colorado ever since I was in my egg. Nothing would make me happier than traveling the world, solving mysteries like he does. So, do you think please take me with you, Mario? I'll help. Come on, let me go. What do you think, Mario?
Sure. Don't take.
Aw, yes, yes, I'm on my way. I swear, I, Cooper, will follow you anywhere, even to the ends of the earth. Alright, guys. More party members. Our second party member of the game is Cooper. Press down to make him throw himself and reach an item or a switch in the distance. While in battle, he can attack an enemy on the ground with Shell Toss, or attack all enemies on the ground with Power Shell. When you want to switch your partner, press right and select the member you want to use. Right on the C-stick, that is. Fantastic. Alright, so now we can do that, which is pretty dope. Mjork! Oh god, what do you want? I changed my mind, sucker! How about a fight? Aw, dicks. I bet if you refuse him, he joins anyways. Probably. You guys ready for some Power Shell? Check it. Best move in the game right here. Not even kidding. Love that move. Problem now is I won't be able to kill all these guys unless I do some shit like this. See ya. I don't want to deal with their shit, so bye-bye. 12 more star points for me. Good shit. Mjork, no! We'll be good, we'll be good! You better be, you little fuckers. All right, so let's get back to town because I really do got to stop now. I have to go. Before we do that, let's grab this item. We can use Cooper to grab shit from afar. Got ourselves our first HP plus badge, which is a very, very good badge. Basically gives you 5 plus HP for, you know, equip it with BP though. So it costs BP to get some HP. Both good and bad, I would say. I usually don't use them unless I'm just like, I don't have BP to spare and I don't know what to use it on. But anyways, guys, we will explore Koopa Village in its proper situation. It won't take us long, but we'll check this place out properly next time. But now that we have Cooper, we should be able to go to Koopa Fortress, Koopa Bros Fortress, because remember, Merlon's foretold that we would have a Koopa with a blue shell to help us out, and we have that now, so that's pretty cool. And yeah, on that note, next time on Paper Mario, Koopa Bros Fortress, Chapter 1 shall continue. I'll see you guys then. Peace!